Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. In the last video, I defined what a prime number was in a composite number, and now I'm looking at prime factorization, and that is writing a composite number as a product of prime numbers. So what you want to do is find the prime factorization for the following numbers, and then write your answer in proper exponent form, and I'll show you what that looks like. Just for your refresher from the last video, these are all prime numbers that we looked at. We went up further than that, but those are going to be the ones that we need. We're not going to need any more than that today for this one. So the prime factorization of 12, I'm going to use the tree method, which you might remember from somewhere else. But what I want to do is start with the lowest prime number possible and say, does that prime number go into this number? And it does, because it's even. And when I get a prime number, I'm going to circle it. How many times does 2 go into 12? 6 times. And 6 is not prime, so I need to keep going. Does 2 go into 6? Yes. I'm going to circle it because it's prime. How many times does 2 go into 6? 3. Is 3 prime? Yes, I'm done. So notice I have 2 2's and a 3, and I'm going to write that as 2 to the second power times 3. The correct notation, the smaller number, the lesser number, goes first. So I wouldn't write 3 and then 2 to the second, because 2 is the lesser number. What if you started it differently? What if you said, hey, I think 12 should be 3 times 4? Well, that's fine. 3 is a prime number, 4 isn't. So you'd go again 2 and 2, and you'd see that you get 2 2's and a 3. So the method that you use to find it is kind of up to you, but the final answer needs to be written with the two lesser numbers first and then the 3 in this case. Okay, 75. 2 does not go into 75. 3 does. So I could start with 3 and 3 times 25. And 3 is a prime, but 25 is not. And then 5 goes into 25. So 5 times 5, which is a prime, and I'm finished. So now, to correctly write this, I would say 3 times 5 to the second power. Notice the exponent doesn't have to go first. What has to go first is the lesser number. So 3 and then times 5 squared. If you just write commas here, this is not correct, because this factorization means a multiplication problem. And so you need to show the multiplication as you do that. What about 165? Well, 2 doesn't go because it's not even. And 3 goes into... well, I can add these up. 5 and 6 is 11, plus 1 is 12. So I know that 3 will go. I could also start with 5 here, but I'm just going to stick with my method, which is use the smallest one first and keep going. 3 goes into 16 5 times. I think that's 53. 150, yeah. Okay, then is 53 a prime number? Well, does 2 go into it? No. Does 3, if I add those up, I get 8, so 3 doesn't go. 4 doesn't go. 5 doesn't go. Remember, no even numbers go into odd numbers, so I can kick out 4, 6, 8, and all that. What about 7? 7 times 7 is 49, so that's not going to go. So, in fact, that is the prime factorization of that number. It's only this. No, it can't be. That should have been 55. You know what? Sometimes you make a mistake, you live with it. So if I go up here, 55 times 3, 3 times 5 is 15, and that's 165. How did I know I made a mistake just then? Because I was ready to move on, but then I saw, wait, this has a 5 at the end. 5 has to go into that. And so I caught myself before I went too far. Remember, this should not be circled. Remember that people make mistakes. It doesn't mean that you're not good at math. It doesn't mean you should quit doing math. It just means, hey, mistakes happen. If you catch it before you get too far along, then you're fine. 165 is 3 times 5 times 11. 5 times 11 is 55 times 3. You can see that that works. You can always check prime factorization by putting it back into your calculator and checking. Let me show you how to check that second one. 3 5 to the second power, 3 times 5 to the second power, 3, let me clear all this out, 3 times 5 to the second power equals 75. So when you're finished, you can always go back and multiply and see if that actually works out. Okay, a few more. We'll see. We don't want to go too long on this video. You might want to try these on your own and then come back and see how you did. 567. Now, my last mistake I made, because I did the division in my head up there. So maybe you don't want to do that. Maybe I shouldn't do that either. Let's see. 7 and 6 is 13, plus 5 is 18. That's how I know that 3 will go into this number. 3 is on my list of prime numbers. But this time, maybe I don't want to make that same mistake. So I'm going to go 567 divided by 3. And that's going to give me 189. Okay, now I can do 9 and 8 is 17 plus 1 is 18. So 3 goes again. Now I can divide that by 3, and that gives me 63. Well, 3 goes into that again. I can divide 63 by 3 to get 21. And 3 goes into 21 again to get 7. That's a prime number. So this one, 567, actually has 1, 2, 3, 4 threes, or 3 to the 4th power times 7. All right, anytime I have an even number like 182, I'm going to start it by dividing by 2. 2 would give me 91. And here's a tricky one. 91 is a composite number, but a lot of people think it looks prime. But it turns out that 7 goes into 91. If you're not sure what goes, you can try everything, but it's not going to go 2 because 2 is an even number and this one isn't, or all the even numbers are kicked out for that reason. If I add 9 and 1, I get 10, so 3 doesn't go. 5 doesn't go because it doesn't end in a 5. So the next thing I would try would be 7, and it turns out 7 goes 13 times. So I have 7, which is a prime number, and 13, which is a prime number, and my answer is 2 times 7 times 13. Notice I don't have any exponents there, but I did write it from least to greatest. 355, I'm going to start off by dividing by 5. I can see 2 doesn't go, and if I add those up, I get 13. So 3 doesn't go, so 5 does, and if I want to make sure I don't make any more mistakes, I can divide that on my calculator, 71. And then the question is 71 a prime number? Well, 2 doesn't go because it's even. If you add these up, you get 8, so 3 doesn't go. It's odd, so cancel out all odd numbers. 5, well, 5 doesn't go into 71 because it doesn't end in a 5 or a 0. 6, 8, 10, all those are out. 7 goes into 70, so it doesn't go into 71. 9, nope. 11, no. And now I'm bigger than I can possibly get. So that's it. My prime factorization is going to be 5 times 71. Okay, and there's 3 more, and I'm going to say that this video has gone on long enough. You might want to try those. Just to see how you do. If I was doing something like this, I would keep using 5 and get down to that. Even though I didn't start with the greatest one, I might make a mistake like that, but when I state my final answer, I'm going to state my answer correctly. And that is 5 to the second, 2 to the second power, 5 to the third power. So I wanted to show you one where there was more than one exponent. Okay, have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.